You have to excuse the pictures because they are a bit grainy. These have been taken off the internet, and this is a developing story as we speak. He was 63, not out. Stood there quite stunned for a while, then face first, straight into the pitch. Now, medicos came onto the ground. The play was abandoned temporarily at the time. Doctors worked on him for up to 30 minutes. Before play was abandoned completely for the day. He was knocked out cold, and there were reports that CPR was attempted too. He's currently listed as critical, has been rushed to hospital. A helicopter did arrive on the ground at the SCG, but he did leave via road in an ambulance. As mentioned, he is at hospital as we speak in a critical condition.
Hear whether this surgery was a success. Now today we've seen a number of members of his cricketing team appear here in a show of support for their mate, the first Australian cricket captain, Michael Clarke. Now he was here for the second day running and turned up at around 7 a.m. in duck sunglasses, quickly entering the building. We've also seen Brad Haddin. He was on the field at the SCG when the incident happened, so obviously very traumatic for him. Now he spent around 40 minutes here to see his mate. We haven't seen a sign of the family yet. We do know that his mother and sister, they were also at the SCG yesterday for the Sheffield Shield. They were here yesterday, and his father wasn't. He was travelling to Sydney to be by his son's side. Now, just to take you through a timeline of events, just briefly, Phillip Hughes was 63 not out at the Sheffield Shield when he was hit by that bouncer and then collapsed.